Hi everyone, it's Tony. In today's video, I'm going to show you how to remove duplicates in Excel. I'm going to cover two methods in this video. Both have their own merits, although personally, I prefer the second one. Let me know in the comments which one you prefer. Okay, are you ready? I know I am, and let's go. Here I have my data set with a list of names, region, and cells, and I want to remove the duplicates. The first question you need to ask yourself is, do you want to keep the original data? So in this example, I will. So let's make a copy of this. Next, I select any cell within the data set, and then I go to the data tab, and then under the data tools group, I click remove duplicates. It's automatically recognized the headings. If it doesn't, just tick this box here. Click OK. It's found four duplicates, which it's removed. To give you another example, you can also remove duplicates from a column. So perhaps I just want a list of the names. So let's make a copy of this column here. Then we go back to remove duplicates, click OK, and it's removed nine duplicates. So I'm just left with the names. That was the first method. Let's have a look at the second one. For this one, we're going to use a new function called unique. The thing I love about this one is that it's dynamic. Let me show you. If you haven't already, convert your data set into a table. The quick way to do this is to select any cell within the range and then press Ctrl T. An easy way to remember this is T for Tony. Click OK. Next, select the cell where you want the results to go. So I'm going to click here, then enter equals, then unique. This new function is available in Microsoft 365 and the online version of Excel, which is also available on the free version. So I select the function by pressing tab on the keyboard, and all I need to do next is select this table. Now the quick way to select this table is to hover your mouse pointer here until you get the tilted arrow like this, and then click. You've got your table selected, close the brackets, press enter, and it pulls the unique values in, removing the duplicates. It doesn't bring in the heading, so let's fix this. And it doesn't pick up the formatting, but that's easy to fix too. So if I click here, click the format painter, and then select the range. And I'm gonna do a bit more, just in case this table gets bigger. The advantage of this method is that it's dynamic. So if I add a new row here, and it's unique, it will automatically update. Whereas in the first method, it doesn't. For the first method, you would need to repeat the steps. If you found this useful, please click like so it can reach more people, and I will see you in the next video.